झले देखे एक चक्रार बसती, दीते नाही उपमा सर्वांशे शोभा आती। भक्ति रत्नाकर रिटन बाय श्री नरहरि चक्रवर्ती ठाकुर, द ग्रेटेस्ट सर्विटर ऑफ राधा गोविंद देव इन जयपुर, द हाइएस्ट नित्य सिद्ध रसिकस हु सॉ ऑल द पास्ट टाइम्स इन हिज विजन, इवन दो ही वॉज नॉट फिजिकली प्रेजेंट एट दैट टाइम, एंड ड्यू टू हिज एक्सट्रीम ह्यूमिलिटी, सो ही राइट्स दिस पास्ट टाइम ऑफ श्री जाह्नवी देवी सीइंग द नित्य लीला ऑफ श्री एक चक्र धाम। सो दिस वर्स स्टार्ट्स बाय स्वप्न छले देखे। सो अगेन द स्वप्न वर्ड इज कमिंग ड्रीम्स, सो स्वप्न छले छले मीन्स ऑन द प्रिटेक्स्ट ऑफ अ ड्रीम, सो बाय लाइंग डाउन, सो इट वॉज नॉट ड्यूरिंग वॉकिंग और सिटिंग अपराइट, और इट वॉज जाह्नवी देवी सॉ इट व्हेन शी वॉज लाइंग डाउन एंड स्लोली डिवाइन विजन अपियर्ड टू हर। शी सॉ द डिवाइन बसती, बसती मीन्स इनहैबिटेंट्स द रेसिडेंट्स द डिवाइन अबोर्ड ऑफ द नित्य एक चक्र, not the Bhauma Eka Chakra, because when she had come at that time the Bhauma Eka Chakra was totally like abandoned, everybody had left because without Nitai they were feeling very very sad in Eka Chakra, they couldn't look at the beauty of Eka Chakra, they would faint unconscious, so this was obviously not the at that time, because Nitai was there till 12 years in his manifest pastime, so he never actually had the Yogapit Leela with Janvi and Vasudha. And when he returned back, also there were no Hadai and Padmavati there. So this is Nitya Leela. This is Nitya Leela, which Jahnavi Devi is seeing with by lying down. All the greatest Nitya Siddha Parikars and Acharyas, they have visions while lying down in a trance. When they lie down, they fall unconscious and they see. So lying down is a very very common thread, and it is very illustrative of the fact that how lying down always enhances your visions. That's why I recommend that in Nitai Leela Dhyan, one should lie down and then visualize Nitai's Leela on the wall with open eyes, and then close the eyes and say it within. Not only that, you can chant Hari Nam while lying down. You can just do hearing while lying down, and you can do everything, whatever, read while lying down. Whatever you do while lying down, the internal visualization is enhanced. So dite nahi upma sarvanshe shobhati. One cannot compare the beauty of Eka Chakra, which she saw in her trance. There is no comparison in the whole creation. A beautiful sarvanshe, every single part of Eka Chakra, whichever rasa, everything is conscious, everyone is conscious, and every single grass, piece of grass, every single object is extremely, extremely beautiful. That's eternally beautiful, wrapped in absorption of Nitai Leela. So, all this she was seeing while lying down and in a trance, in a divine vision. Then the Bhakti Ratnakar 11th Taranga, 635th verse, means after 7 verses, there are each chapter is like a Taranga or wave in Bhakti Ratnakar. When Bhakti Ratnakar is actually authorized by Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada in his commentary, and he says it's extremely beautiful, he himself printed it. Bhakti Ratnakar, and Bhakti Ratnakar has the greatest secrets of the Leelas of Gopal Bhatti Goswami and Jeev Goswami, which were not revealed even in Chaitanya Charitamrita, and these were revealed by Srila Narhari Chakravarti Thakur. By remembering his feet, I am singing the second verse. श्री जानवा एकौतुक मने विचारिते हैल निद्रा भंग पुनो आकर्षे निद्राते. And you may say, no, swapna means she had this divine dream, but that means that she may not be lying down, she may be just sitting or something. No, again it is confirmed that she was actually lying down, sleeping. And this beautiful Kautuka, this astonishing beauty which she saw, she was remembering it very deeply, like we do during Nitai Leela Dhyan. We see the beauty of the Nitya Eka Chakra while lying down, and Haila Nidra Bhanga, and suddenly her sleep broke and she awakened. Now when she awakened, her vision kind of disappeared, stopped, because like she woke up and she got up. But then her vision was not complete. I mean, she was so eager to see more. So again she lay down. Punaha akarshite nidrate. Again, the sleep attracted her, and she lay down again. So see, you see how important it is to lie down. The same thing which is happening with all our Nitya Lila Dhyayaks. Like when they sit upright or they get up, they lose their vision on the walls. They lose their internal vision of the Lila. But when they immediately when they lie down, then everything suddenly appears. Whatever food they have eaten or whatever consciousness they are, doesn't matter. Even if they are sleep deprived, doesn't matter. So this is the beauty. This you can see in its eternal purest form in Janvi Devi also. Again, the sleep overcame her, and again she was lying down. And then Puna Swapna Dekhe Ek Chakra Nadi Tire Nana Pushpa Kanana Apurva Shobha Kare. This is the 36th verse of the 11th Taranga Bhakti Ratnakar. The very next verse, Punaha Swapna Dekhe, again she saw the divine vision as she was laid down. Again she saw. Immediately it started the divine darshan. Eka Chakra Naditire. She saw the beautiful Modeshwari Jamuna, which is very dear to Nitai, and all his associates in Eka Chakra. Nana Pushpa Kanana. She saw many different varieties of flower forests, beautiful flower forests, bowers, gardens, kunjas. Kananam is actually forests, beautiful, beautiful forests. She saw as she was lying down in her trance, Apurva Shobha Kare. And they were so beautiful. Like that's why you see even Janvi Devi is meditating on Shantaras in Eka Chakra. You say, oh, why we should see the forests? We should just see Janvi, Vasudha and Nitai, or you know, devotees saying we should just meditate on Radha Krishna, Manjari Bhav, and why we should see the forests. But without Shantarasa, without taking in the Dham's beauty, one cannot actually enter there and serve in one's Swarupa. Vansiddha Deha. So Janvi Devi saw Nana Pushpa Kanana Apurva Shobha Kare. Apurva, Apurva, unparalleled beauty and shimmering in divine beauty and resplendent. Resplendent beauty of the beautiful Eka Chakra on the banks of the river Maudeshwari Jamuna, which is the waters are like shining, glistening like Nitai himself. So again, all the three verses have Shayana or Swapna or Nidra. So again you see the highest spurtis, the highest darshans of the Nitya Lila can be attained by lying down. That is why Shayana Nitai Lila Dhyan. Shayana means if you lie down while doing Nitai Lila Dhyan, then you are already 50% on the right track. You will see. You will see the divine beauty of Eka Chakra in your Lila Dhyan. For those of you, this is the first audio. It's very simple. You lie down with your head in the south, and you look at a wall in front of you, and you project any Nitya Lila painting, but make a painting into a movie, like your movie, you're seeing, like you're gazing outside a window, like your wall has become like a window. And then when the forms are like internally imprinted in your mind, when you're looking at the wall, and you're like on the wall, then you close your eyes and actually enter there, be there and touch there and serve there and wander there. It's very easy. Nitya Lila Dhyan is effortless practice. So you can try it. It will give you instant Harinam Ruchi. It will give you instant attraction for Gaur Radha Krishna also, because wherever Nita is, Gaura is there, and wherever Gaura is, gopis are there. Wherever gopis are there, Radha Krishna are present. So thank you very much. Shayana Nitai Lila Dhyan Ki Jai, Harinam Ruchi Ki Jai, Guru Parampara Ki Jai, Dandavat Pranams.